Okay, so here is the mandatory requirements for a drainage system. So ito po ay parati laging lumalabas ano po, but there in case there's something na application ang kanilang type of question ano po, but here are the mandatory requirements for a drainage system. It's according to the National Plumbing Code ano po. So number one, that all pipe joints must be well vented. Ano po ang sinasabi dyan? Must be all vented. Wait lang, gagamit ng highlighter. Ano? Sinasabi dyan that must be well fitted. Ano po? Fitted and tightly connected with each other. So in that case, mape-prevent po yung leakage, leakage of gas and liquid. So that is one of the mandatory requirements sa drainage system. So inaasahan na ang lahat is fitted, meaning kapag ka tayo gumagamit ng mga pipes, dapat sila ay connected or fitted and tightly connected. Kailangan walang tagas, So para mape-prevent yung leakage. Diba? Laging nga, primary focus and concern of the drainage system is to promote health and sanitation. So, this is the first mandatory requirement of a drainage system. Kailangan lahat ng pipes and joint must be well-fitted and tightly connected with each other. The second is, the drainage pipe should be graded or inclined properly for a downward gravity of flow of water, di ba? The standard must be 2%. Ano po? So, kailangan yung graded 2% per meter. Ano po? So, kailangan is nasusunod talaga yon. So, kailangan is graded or inclined properly papunta doon sa main sewer or doon sa septic tank. So, and for that case, walang titigil or walang may stock na solid waste or solid material doon sa ating drain system. So, pagkalabas or pagka-flush, kailangan tuloy-tuloy siya papunta doon sa ating septic tank or doon sa ating sewer line. Number 3, that the drainage pipe should be provided with adequate clean out. So, yung clean out, those are part of the drainage system for repair. So, if ever na magkaroon ng clog, or magkaroon ng bara yung isang pipe, hindi natin gagawin is hindi natin siya puputulin o kaya naman hindi natin siya puputulan para makuha. So, ang gagamitin natin for access is yung clean out. And, the drainage system must be provided with ventilation pipe. So, lagi kong sinasabi kanina pa that the drainage system must be connected must be provided with ventilation pipe. Para saan yung ventilation pipe? Yung ventilation pipe is gagamitin to convey the gas to the atmosphere, meaning those obnoxious gases must not be hindi na dapat siya babalik din sa loob ng ng bahay o kaya ng isang building. Kailangan pagka-flush or pagkalabas ng ating waste material or solid waste or liquid waste, kailangan kasama na niya yung obnoxious gases palabas ng atmosphere. Where? Can do no harm to human health. So, kaya nga sinasabi ko kanina, laging concern ng ating plumbing is yung public health. So, if those solid waste o kaya naman ay liquid waste ay magbabara o kaya naman ay mag-i-stuck doon sa ating mga pipes as well as yung obnoxious gases, then it is a health hazard. Pwedeng mag-harm siya doon sa mga tao na naandun sa loob. So ito, lumalabas lagi yan. That except for water closet, each fixture should be provided with suitable trap that will prevent backflow of gases. So ano lang daw, except for water closet. Kailangan lahat na ng fixture should be provided with suitable trap para hindi bumalik or mag-backflow yung gas. Number 6, that the drain system must be vented. Avoid siphonage or backflow of the water seal. So, always, lagi, kung mapapansin ninyo, that lahat ang ating water supply system at saka drain system is always afflicted or inflicted dun sa Ventilation system. Para saan yung ventilation system? Para ma-avoid yung siphonage. Ano yung siphonage? Is yung paghigop. Diba? Pagka nagbuhos ka, parang pakiramdam is po, nauubos yung tubig. Ano? Kaya yung backflow, yung pagbalik nung tubig. That in case, pag bumalik siya, parang naiigahan yung ating P-trap. Ano? So, ibig sabihin, nawawala yung water seal. And in that case, nawawala ng purpose yung P-trap. So, kaya lagi, ano, laging kinakailangan si ventilation system doon sa ating drainage system. Again, here are the mandatory requirements for a drain system. Kailangan lahat ng pipes ay connected, fitted, ano. Next is, kailangan must be grated or inclined properly for downward gravity of water. That the drainage pipe should be provided with adequate clean out. Ano po, para sa yung clean out? Para sa access for repair. Number 4, provided with ventilation pipe that will convey the gas to the atmosphere. Number 5, that except for water closet, okay, maliban sa water closet, lahat na fixture ay dapat may suitable trap. Ano po, at ang drainage system must be vented for avoidance in the siphonage or backflow of water seal. So, let's keep in mind this mandatory requirements. Ano, lumalabas na ito lagi. Hindi masya in a word by word, but it is an application. Ano po? And all those reds can be your guide. Ano po? Para hindi kayo mawawala. So, dahil sa, andito sa drain system, we have this type of waste. Dadalawa naman ito, the solid at saka yung liquid waste. When we say solid waste, ano? So, these are type of waste that are discharged by water closet. So, meaning, ito yung may mga laman. Ano po? So, those are concerned with feces. So, ibig sabihin, may solid. From the word solid, ibig sabihin buo. Ano po? So, imagine nyo na lang yan. Ano? Liquid waste. So, various fixtures. Ano? Sila naman yung mga walang feces. Ano po? So, water closet, ang solid waste. Liquid waste, various fixtures. So, pwede nyo itong tandaan nyo. Pagka water closet, solid waste, or toilet. Ano? And various fixtures, ito naman yung liquid waste. So, we have these two types of drainage piping in accordance with the solid waste at saka liquid waste. We have the soil pipe at saka waste pipe. Pagka soil pipe, so those are pipe. Ano? It is a pipe that conveys the discharge of black water. Pag sinabi natin black water, yun yung liquids containing fecal matter. Ano? So, ibig sabihin, ang soil pipe, ginagamit siya to convey or to discharge this type of waste, which is the solid waste. Ano? Whereas the solid waste are this water discharges by the toilet, meaning those are black water. Again, black water are those waste that contains fecal matter, ano, feces. Okay? So, soil pipe for solid waste because it discharges black water. They use water closet. Ano po? Waste pipe naman, so it is a type of pipe, drainage piping that concerns with the discharge of only gray water. When we say gray water, yan naman yung mga waste, ano po, waste that are free of fecal matter. Ibig sabihin, wala, ano po. So ito, contain, pagka soil pipe, ito naman ay without, ano po, or so free. Meaning, waste pipe can discharge liquid waste. Kasi liquid waste are those type of waste that does not contain fecal matters. Ano po? So, a waste pipe is generally smaller than soil pipe because of the nature of matter being discharged into the system. So, in terms of the diameter, masasabi natin talaga na soil pipe is a much bigger, ano, yung diameter niya. Considering the required diameter is 3 inches or 75 mm. Ano po? So, mas malaki yung soil pipe. It's because the matter that it or it discharges are containing fecal. Ano, hindi naman natin masasabi na maliliit o kaya ay malalaki. So, talagang kailangan is mas malaki to. So, in accordance with the mandatory requirements of the drainage system, kailangan tuloy-tuloy. Ano po? So, kung siya ay maliit, ibig sabihin is hindi niya na-achieve yung mandatory requirement that the all type of waste must be provided equal flow or dire-diretso talaga yung pag-discharge ng waste. So, it's very understandable naman that the soil pipe must have or must be bigger in diameter in terms of size than the waste pipe. So it's because waste pipe can discharge only liquid free of fecal matter, meaning there are no distress, walang makakapigil or talagang tuloy-tuloy lang. So kahit maliit man yan, kaya ay malaki yung size ng size ng pipe ng wire, walang maharang or titigil, unlike dito sa ating soil pipe. Again, there are only two types of waste, the solid, liquid. Pag solid, those are discharges by the water closet or in toilet. Okay, liquid waste naman, those are from various fixtures. So solid waste, water closet, liquid waste, various fixtures. Pag sinabi naman natin types of drainage piping, soil pipe, waste pipe, soil pipe, discharge with black water, or fecal matter, contains fecal, waste pipe naman, gray water, or without, In terms of size, mas malaki si soil pipe rather than the waste pipe. Ano po? Tatandaan po natin yan. So, what are the waste pipe at saka yung ating soil pipe? Number one, unahin mo natin yung waste pipe. Ito yung mga lumalabas lagi, and these are from plumbing code, The waste pipe must be short, meaning hindi niya kinakailangan mahaba, short lang, direct, free from offset, wala dapat liko-liko, and provided with ample clean out. Okay? So ibig sabihin maraming clean out. So para sa niya yung clean out, those are the access for repair or kaya naman ay may bara, So again, the waste pipe must be short, direct, free from offset. So those are the three requirements for a waste pipe, and provided with ample clean outs. Those three, yung mga naka-highlight is talagang yan yung mga mahalaga. So ano ba yung right slope para sa grade ng isang waste pipe? The ideal position of horizontal waste pipe were those installed at 2% slope, meaning 2%. Kung meron tayong 1 meter, ibig sabihin yung inclined ratio or the inclination ratio would be 2 centimeters. So meaning pag 2 centimeters, pagka may 1 meter tayo, kailangan may 2 centimeters yung ating inclination. So for instance, or on the example, kung kailangan mo ng 3 meters na pipe para sa ating waste pipe, maggamit tayo ng inclination. So, 3 meters times 2 centimeters, ibig sabihin, kailangan natin ng 6 centimeters of inclination. Again, the pipe or the waste pipe must be short, direct, free from offset, and provided with ample clean out. Lagi yan tatandaan, 2% ang kanyang inclination ratio. Oh, ito naman, kanina yung sa waste pipe, ito naman yung sa soil pipe, according to the National Plumbing Code. Sinasabi sa ating soil pipe that one of the vertical stacks in the plumbing system must extend the size or the full size through the roof for the following purposes. Ano yung vertical stack? Diba? Vertical stacks are used para maglabas ng mga obnoxious gases and or tumulong siya dun sa ating drainage piping. So ano yung purpose ng vertical stack? Number one, to ventilate and dispose of the sewer gases above the roof. So mahalaga naman yan, diba? So it's very understandable na yung vertical stack natin, yung parang pag-anon sa taas, above ng roof, ibig sabihin talagang ventilation. Okay, ibig sabihin talagang it facilitates the proper recirculation and dispose. Ibig sabihin, siya yung magdi-dispose or siya yung maglalabas ng mga sewer gas above the roof. Okay, so if there is no problem with that, kung meron tayong vertical stack, there will be no problem in the drainage piping or dun sa ating drainage system kasi there will be no backflow or siphonage of the obnoxious gases kasi nga po meron tayong vertical stack. Yun yung first purpose ng ating vertical stack. Number two, to prevent siphoning of the water trapped sealed by force of suction. So, ibig sabihin, talagang pagka nagbuhos tayo, dire-diretso yung pag-flow ng water, it's because hindi nababalik yung hangin kasi there is an open an open exit ano through the midst of this vertical stack. Hindi babalik ano. So kung na-imagine niyo yung pagbalik kasi nga there are no area or there are no end point of exit dun sa ating mga water. Kaya nagkakaroon tayo ng siphoning or backflow. And when that happens, babalik or magsisiphoning, then therefore, pag nagsiphoning yun, yung water seal trap ay maiiga. Then therefore, there are no water or there are no effective seal in the P trap. Then yung obnoxious gases is freely roaming around dun sa ating area or dun sa ating toilet. But those can be prevented through the use of this vertical stack. Ano? Yung vertical stack siya yung mag-facilitate ng proper air point of exit ng obnoxious gases palabas so that there will be no siphoning ano dun sa ating water trap seal. Ano po? So and last purpose of this vertical stack is to prevent the possibility of back pressure. Ano? These three are all in connected ano with the drainage piping and the air ventilation system. Kaya nga kanina ko pa sinasabi that you cannot achieve a great drainage piping if the air vent system are not properly facilitating din. Ano? So those three systems in the house plumbing system are must be coordinating properly from the water supply, coordinate siya dapat sa air vent system, and sa ating drainage piping, coordinated din dapat siya sa ating air vent system. And these are some of the purpose on what is the meaning or what is the ano yung kahalagahan or importance of this air vent system through this drainage system. Ano po? So, to ventilate and dispose, to prevent siphoning, and to prevent the possibility of back pressure. So you have to take note of this kasi lagi naman siya. Ano? So in other words, those are important. Ano? Meaning, hindi man siya directly na ito itatanong, but those can be in a form of application or can be in a form of analysis. Ano po? So ano pa yung sinasabi ng National Plumbing Code sa ating soil pipe? That any structure with a house drain installed, ano, masabi at least one soil stack or stack vent, ano, lagi yan, connected siya, stack vent, extended full size above the roof, not less than 30 cm long and should not be less than 75 mm or 3 inches diameter or the size of the drain, whichever is smaller. So, you have to take note of this, na lahat ng structure sa bahay ay kailangan may isa. Ano, may isang stack vent ano na mag-extend hanggang sa taas for this purpose, yung tatlong ito na hindi dapat maliit ng 30 cm long yung exceeds ano dun sa taas ng roof. Okay, kailangan yung taas ng roof is, let's say for example, kung ang iyong height ng roof is nasa 100 cm, kailangan yung extension of the stack vent must be 30 cm above. Ano? So, meaning, kailangan is 130 cm yung iyong stack vent. Ano? At hindi daw dapat liliit. Ano? Should not be less than 3 inches diameter or the size of the drain, whichever is smaller. So, you have to take note of this because it is from the National Plumbing Code. So, kailangan lahat ng structure is merong isang soil stack or stack vent. Kailangan sila is extended full size above the roof. Hindi liliit ng 30 cm at hindi magle-less than ng 3 inches in diameter. So, as a general rule, vent stack must be extended and terminate through the roof of the building. So kung ang ating roof ay gagamitin other than protection kasi talagang very ano naman 'yan, 'di ba? Very ano na tayo ngayon, very economical na ipagamit natin ng roofing system, 'di ba? Kasi gumagamit tayo ng slab, ano. So let's say for example, pwede siyang guest o kaya naman guest house o kaya naman ay ginagamit siya as party area, ano. So, ang stack vent should be extended no less than 2 meters above the roof. Ano po? So, yan. Yung rule. If the roof is not to be used other than protection, ano po? So, kailangan is 2 meters above. So, kanina, if you notice, if the roof is not being used other than protection, ano, so 30 cm long ang kailangan niya, but if the roof is to be used, ano, other than protection, so it is advisable that you have to extend ng hindi bababa ng 2 meters. So, I hope this would be a great help sa inyo, ano. So, kasi ito ay nasa national plumbing code. So, kailangan naiintindihan kasi baka itanong ito ng PRC, ano po. So, sa ating drain system, di ba? The septic tank is the receptacle or vault that holds our waste, ano. So, dun sa ating septic tank, meron tayong 2 types of waste, di ba? So, atin munang tingnan yung ating definition of the septic tank. Pag sinabi natin septic tank, receptacle or vault, ano, para siya, kaya siya tinawag na vault is para siyang naka-square, di ba? So, dito nag-hold and deposit of this collected organic waste discharged from the house sewer. So, meaning, if we discharge our human waste, diyan pupunta sa ating receptacle or vault na yan, yung septic tank. So, what is the ideal size? So, for 6 family members, you're required to have this 1.3 cubic meter. Ano? So, ganyan yung hinihingi sa atin. So, a very large tank is not advisable because the bacterial activities would not be retarded. So, meaning, kapag ka sobrang laki, ibig sabihin yung, di ba, we have these 2 types of bacteriological processes dun sa, ano, the anaerobic and the sedimentation process, ano. So, those cannot be facilitated if talagang yung gagamit tayo ng very large tank. Ano, pag very large tank, meaning, nagkakaroon ng alteration, yung anaerobic and sedimentation process na nangyayari dun sa scum at saka sa sludge, ano, so hindi siya advisable. Hindi napafacilitate yung process or yung proper bacterial activities na nangyayari dun sa ilalim. Ano po? So, what are those bacteriological process? Pag sa sludge, ano, tingnan mo natin, sludge. Sludge, saan siya nasa bottom? Ano? Sludge accumulated at the bottom. Semi-liquid substance accumulated at the bottom. Ibig sabihin, nasa baba. Ano? Yun yung nasa baba. Pagka-scum, so floating substance, ano, at the septic tank. So, meaning, siya yung mga bagong labas. Ano? Pagka-sludge, siya yung mga matagal na or ano. So, what are those bacteriological process? When we say sedimentation, so those are the bacteriological process that happens at the upper portion, meaning on the scum. Ano po? So, decomposition in the upper portion. And anaerobic decomposition or anaerobic process, meaning it is a decomposition of the sludge. Ano? Wherein the sludge is located at the bottom. Ano? At the bottom of the tank. Okay? Pagka scum, from the word S, ano, letter S, scum, sedimentation. Sludge naman, same lang pala yun, ano. Pagka sedimentation process, ibig sabihin sa scum, ano. Pagka anaerobic, meaning ito ay sa sludge. So, again, bacteriological process that happens on the scum, sedimentation. Bacteriological process that happens on the sludge, anaerobic decomposition. Okay po? So, maliwanag sana tayo doon. Ano po? So, the minimum distance required being between the septic tank and the residence. Okay, so yan. Septic tank to residence is 10 feet. Ano? So, kailangan yung layo ng septic tank sa residence is 10 feet. Ang layo ng well or yung water supply system can be, okay? So, well can be a source of water. Ano? At saka ng septic tank is 75 feet. So, ganyan kalayo. Ano po? So, dapat pagka ang septic tank sa residence, 10 feet, ang well, at saka ang septic tank is 75 feet. So, you have to take note of this kasi maraming lumalabas na ganito. Ano po? So, it is in regards with the National Plumbing Code. So, you have to take note of this. So, as part of the drainage system, we have this house drain. So, it is the portion of the plumbing system that receives and discharges of all solid soil and waste within the building. So, it's also known as or referred to known as the collection line of plumbing system. Pag sinabi natin collection line, ito ay yung house drain. Okay? So, ano yung plumbing code on house drain? That no water closet shall be discharged into a drain less than 75 millimeter or 3 inches pipe diameter. Kaya yung sinasabi ko sa inyo, kanina nga, di ba? So, soil pipe must be greater in diameter rather than the waste pipe. So, if you could imagine, yung 3 inches, malaki na yan, ano? So, wala nang, ano dyan, wala nang babara or wala nang titigil dyan. So, walang water closet, ha? No water closet shall be in less than. Meaning, ito na yung pinaka-minimum. Ano po? So, pwedeng mas malaki dito, but this should be the minimum standard. Ano po? So, kailangan is 3 inches ang pipe diameter. So, again, ito pa. I'm very much sure lumabas na ito. Ano po? Ito ay lumabas na. So, no more than 2 water closets shall discharge into any 75 millimeter horizontal soil branch, house drain, or house sewer. Sinasabi dyan, no 2 water closet. Ano? Ibig sabihin talagang kailangan isa lang. Okay? Kung ano, isa-isa lang. Okay? So, kailangan hindi, no more than. No more than 2 water closet. Okay? So, hindi dapat lalabas sa dalawa. Okay? So, dapat, if ever pa nga, dapat isa-isa lang. Pero, kung gagamit tayo ng soil branch, dapat is dalawa lang. Ano po? So, kaya, ano, nagkakaroon tayo ng problem kasi nilalamihan na, dinadamihan or nagkakaroon ng dikit-dikit. Dapat ay not more than, okay, no more than 2 water closet. Again, those are the plumbing code on house drain. So, these are types of plumbing pipes. So, pag sinabi natin stainless, okay, so one of the most corrosion resistant materials available to plumbers for in hot and cold water services. Para saan siya, hot and cold water services. However, these are great, ano, mas maganda talaga to, stronger than copper, tsaka mas mas magaan, ano, tsaka yung rigidity of this is an advantage. So, talagang maganda siyang gamitin sa ating mga piping. However, these are not advisable because of the economic, masyado siyang mahal, ano, these are more expensive. Pero kung titingnan talaga natin, these are great, ano, these are great materials in type of any type of plumbing system. So, kaya nga lang, mas maganda siya kung hot and cold, and at the same time, mas matibay siya sa copper at mas magaan. Kaya nga lang, talagang mas may kamahalan yung ating stainless. Ano po? So, GA pipe, it is used to convey potable water. Ano po? So, especially kung magdadala tayo ng water sa bahay. PVC naman, it's used for high pressure water. Ano po? So, kung kanina stainless, hot and cold, ito naman high pressure water, ito naman used in carrying potable water. Okay? Hot and cold, potable, ito naman high pressure water. Okay? So, usually white or gray in color. Yun yung kulay niya. The block polyethylene, ano po, so highest in demand in the rural sector for water reticulation system. So ito yung mga madalas natin nakikita na nagagamit for water reticulation, meaning pag-deliver or pag-supply ng water. So plumbing, which is the Republic Act 1378 or the plumbing law, ano po. So, establish that will protect the health of the community. Lagi kong sinasabi kanina that the plumbing was the main purpose or the purpose of plumbing is to have an effective water supply in the building and discharge of sewer gases. Ano po? Which is advisable for us to have a great minimum health standard para sa hindi tayo magkakasakit kasi nga lahat ng inalabas natin is our health concerns. Ano po? Those are health hazards. So, with the increasing standardization of equipment, materials, plumbing codes in different areas are tending more and more toward uniformity. So, ibig sabihin talagang ginagamit natin ito para iisa lang yung ating sinusunod na techniques. And magkaroon tayo ng standardization. Ano po? So, yun yung purpose ng plumbing law. So, this is the Republic Act 1378, also known as the plumbing law. So, I'm very much confident, everyone, na please, if you have time, kindly browse this R8-1378 for you to have more or mas marami pang ideas or kaalaman. Ano po?